Can you hear me?
Now I can.
Well, all right. Good.
Good? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Steel Series, Southeast Asian Cup Season 4. This is Game 1 of a best of 3 between Loya.net Esports and Titan. Both of these are Malaysian teams, and they have faced each other multiple times before, so it should be a good game coming up. Thank you, of course, to SteelSeries for sponsoring this tournament. Shout out to datbet.net esports betting. And thank you to DotaTalk for very kindly allowing me to cast this. And Pimpmuckle, are you doing co-casting today?
Yeah, if you're okay with it.
Yeah, cool. All right. Well, welcome Pimpmuckle as well. He's going to be doing the camera work and some co-casting on the side there. So, when was the last time you saw these two teams versus each other? Have you seen them recently or not really?
Oh, I don't even know. I think they played in GPL. I'm not quite sure.
Yeah, they did.
I saw a lot of Loya.net, and well, they played quite nicely. So, I have to unmute myself in game. Thanks, Mr. Method. It's always the same because I don't play with open mic in a pub. Well.
Yeah.
So Clockwork first pick. I guess it's fine. I would have expected a Lifestealer, but
really?
Ohio on his Clockwork is sick. Yeah.
Lifestealer, I've seen. Quite ignored thus far in this tournament. I think I've only seen him picked up once or twice. I was honestly expecting maybe a Timbersaw being picked up, but Loya.net have got the opportunity to take the Timbersaw now if they wanted. I don't know, Lifestealer is just really faded out from what I've seen. Plus it's a Miracle playing carry, so I'm expecting Miracle to play something more split pushy. I mean, Naga Siren's been banned out, but you know, could be a Morphling or I don't know.
Yeah.
Phantom Lance Anti-Mage.
He has a lot of heroes to choose from. I mean, the Phantom Lancer and the Anti-Mage aren't like exactly in the meta right now, but Miracle can make them work, and he made a Morphling work, so I'm pretty confident he can make like every hero work if he can get some nice split push going on. And yeah.
Yeah, he just needs to get a little bit of farm up and he's able to carry the team forward. But yeah, Loya banning out the Nagasar and the Alchemist, so pretty standard. We could see Loya picking up the Mirana now. They go for the Visage first pick, so a really strong support with that. And they either want to secure another offlaner now, so maybe the Elder Titan, maybe the Timbersaw, like I was saying. Or they could pick up a carry like a Weaver or a Mirana, something to farm in the tri lane. They probably do want to finish the game fairly early, though. They don't want to drag it on. So an early game carry, something like the Weaver, which is what they will be going for, I think will suit them quite well at this point. Giving them a starting a really strong tri lane, as well as some early game DPS and potential for nice negative armor, since Visage normally does pick up that medallion and with the swarm as well. And it might give them a quite easy chance to go for the Roshan filler into the game to just give them the ability to go high ground.
Yeah, if they can manage to secure an early lead or a nice team fight somewhere in the proximity of Roshan, they will take him down quite easily. And what I like about the Weaver, he needs the Lincoln Sphere and then he can fight. Just because of his Shukuchi dealing so much damage in the early phases of the game. And he's hard to catch, so you have to, you know, get sentries, get dust and all that jazz on the supports, and it starves them.
Yeah, it really does. And it also means that Titan have to consider picking up some kind of dedicated stunner, to kind of chase that Weaver down, or else he's just going to run amok in team fights. I mean, Clockwork's okay at it, using they're called Power Cogs? I never knew they were called Power Cogs. Well, you learn something new every day. Using the Power Cogs to sap his mana a little bit, as well as the Rocket to give some scouting. And Rubick is quite nice against the Weaver with the Telekinesis and then able to steal out the Shukuchi, giving him a nice chasing ability as well as initiation skill. But still, we might like to see Titan picking up some other kind of, dedicated stunning hero design to just chase that Rubick down. They banned out the Puck, interestingly enough, so maybe they're interested in picking up a Storm Spirit as one of the kind of mid-core heroes. It's probably going to be KYXY playing the mid, I would assume, in Ohio in the offlane. But maybe banning out the Viper as well. Feels like maybe they're going for a Storm Spirit pickup.
Wow,
could be
interesting.
Wrong,
and also interesting to note, Loya.net bans out a Timbersaw, while Clockwork is already on Titan, so they might expect a Clockwork middle.
They might, I guess. I mean, Clockwork does get a bit of grief from the Puck as well as the Viper, but I guess maybe they just didn't want to have to deal with even the possibility of versing a Timbersaw, since Timbersaw is such an annoying hero, especially when you have got those kind of low health heroes that really drop fast from the pure damage coming out from the Timbersaw, like the Weaver and... I mean, maybe they're going to pick up something like a Crystal Maiden as well to go with that Weaver for extra mana.
Yeah, you're right. Timbersaw can pretty much one-shot a Weaver in the early stages of the game, and he can just make it so hard for the Weaver to get up his essential Lincoln Sphere. And also with the Lincoln Sphere, I mean, it blocks single-target stuff, and Timbersaw doesn't care about the Lincoln Sphere at all. So you have to pick up a BKB, and if you pick up a Lincoln Sphere and a BKB, well, that's no damage coming out. And a Sand King pickup, so we saw that yesterday, and It didn't work out too well, but the idea was pretty nice behind it. Just with so much lockdown.
Well, I've seen Senking at least in two or three games today already. So I mean, he's apparently just become a super popular pick in the Southeast Asian scene. I suppose with the Visage, that is an okay lineup for him to be able to get in range for that stun. But I mean, usually with the Senking, you either want to leave him kind of pulling to get some farm up, or just aggressively ganking with something like a Bane or a Shadow Demon, someone to can lead up the stun for him to get into range. But I don't know, Visage and Senking, like Visage is another hero that also needs to be pulling. I mean, usually you take, you know, a Visage and a Crystal Maiden or a hero that's non-experience dependent. But Visage and Senking are both experience dependent and item ex as a Storm Spirit and item dependent support heroes. So picking them up together is quite interesting. Maybe Lo Yad are gonna be running an aggressive tri lane. I mean, normally we don't see aggressive tri lanes coming out from them, but I can't imagine how else they're gonna be, you know, trying to get the levels onto these supports unless they just go fully aggressive and get the hero kills.
Yeah, and the Storm Spirit middle is a bit fragile, but as soon as he hits level 6 and he will get the levels like one way or another, you can't really gank him with a Sand King and a Visage just because Sand King stun isn't like that high of a range. And it's also not that easy because the Storm Spirit can stay kind of defensive if he gets the call of the supports missing from the Lo Yad lane. And a Lone Druid pickup. Wow, we don't see a lot of Lone Druid at all. Do we?
Yeah, that is a pretty interesting pickup. I mean, what we have been seeing from Lo Yat recently is a tri-core lineup. They have been picking up, you know, Lifestealer to go in the offlane, but it looks like Weaver could be mid, quite honestly. I've seen them run Weaver mid a couple of times on DDZ. Lo Yat probably going to be run Lone Druid in the offlane. They've got room for one more pickup. Weaver could be mid, or they could pick up something else. I mean, maybe they could even be having the Sand King go mid against the Storm Spirit. I mean, it is kind of, I guess, an option. It depends on what they want to do, but I'm assuming Lo Yat are going to pick up one more core. Maybe the Marana who's still in the pool, or they might want to take someone with a bit more, I guess, AoE. But Titan are going to take the Lifestealer themselves. Well,
Oh,
that's a bit of
hello.
interesting. Especially against the Weaver and the Lone Druid. Two heroes are typically thought to counter the Lifestealer. Weaver being able to kite him around, and Lone Druid with the Entangling Roots. It's a bit interesting.
Oh, good thing is the Lifestealer just chews through the bear because of his feast. And if he gets some nice items up, the bear's gonna drop pretty fast because they don't really have anything of DPS yet. But I expect them to pick up. Well, actually, no, that doesn't make sense. I thought about another core, but then Clockwork would have been played as a support, and I don't see that working out. So, what do they pick for the last support? Is it gonna be something like a Lein or a Lina just with high burst damage? Just to shut down
For
this Weaver?
Titan?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like they want a little bit more AoE. They've got really nice pickoff ability with both the Clockwork and Wills, the Storm Spirit, and Lifestealer as well. I mean, that's going to be a really nice bomb for the Storm Spirit and Lifestealer just kind of jump inside. And I mean, with that, they're going to be able to get some, you know, really aggressive ganks going at the start of the game. But with Lo Yat now picking up a Razor, so there's that tri-core we were just talking about, and a nice counter pick to the Lifestealer as well. So as a support, like, I think a Lion would do okay, but they might want to take something with, you know, like a THD maybe for that little bit more team fight, or a Leshrac, who's been another kind of popular hero. Of course, they're going to have to watch out because any of those really high DPS heroes are quite squishy, and picking up a melee one like the Earthshaker or the Tidehunter is going to be, I think, a bit too many melee heroes in their lineup, you know, versus a Sand King that's going to be leading to a bit of grief.
Yeah.
But I don't know, it looks like a hard situation because any of those, you know, single
5
point
seconds remaining.
target, you know, stunners like the Lion or Rast or anything like that, they're just going to get shut down by the Razor because of his passive. But at the same time, if they don't have lockdown, I think that, you know, Weaver's just going to go completely crazy. They've only got, well, one or two stuns at the moment. Storm Spirit with the Electric Vortex of Rubick with the Telekinesis. But I mean, other than that, unless they trap him in the cogs and he doesn't have his ultimate up, I think Weaver's just going to be going absolutely crazy.
Yeah, it's gonna be interesting to see what their last pick. As you said, the draft from Lo Yat is kind of strong, and a Wind Ranger. So there is some lockdown, but it's kind of unreliable, and I'm not too sure how they're gonna now lane this if it's gonna be an aggressive tri lane coming out. Because they have a really, really well, they had the stronger tri lane, I would say, in the early levels until the Sand King gets some levels and experience done, and they could shut down this Weaver quite a bit. If the Weaver's gonna farm the tri lane? Yeah, I guess so.
But I mean, the thing that Lo Yat have really got going for them is they've got a nice, I guess, split pushing lineup with DDZ picking up the Lone Druid, and with Weaver also being able to split push. I mean, Titan have got a kind of anti-split push lineup, I guess, as well, with KYXY and Ohayo playing the Clockwork and the Storm Spirit. But I mean, Lo Yan, if they can just turtle until around about the 30 to 40 minute mark, they're going to have a tri-core versus a single, I guess, dual core coming out from Titan. And honestly, I've never really seen, I mean, I guess I have a couple of times, but Miracle playing more aggressive type heroes that are early game aggressive rather than late game farming. I mean, we saw him play that Luna last night, and he just got absolutely destroyed. He was something like 0 to 7, wasn't he?
Yeah.
He had a really sad game as Luna, so
What a
I wonder how
start.
he's going to go on this Lifestealer.
Well, thing
That was
is, he
funny.
bounced
That was
back
targeting.
like a boss. He was like, what,
Yeah.
0-8 or something? Or 2-8? It was miserable. He got outfarmed by the enemy supports, and somehow he just got his GPM up to 500. I have no clue how he did it, just winning teamfights with his Eclipse. And yeah, then he just carried the game. It was great to see.
Yeah.
And well, thing is, Luna
Well.
carries a bit harder than a Lifesteal, I would say, just because of her glaives bouncing through. So we'll see
Yeah,
what he will do in the early game.
I mean, Lifesteal is okay, but I mean, he can carry late game if he's against really tanky carries, but Loyat, I mean, they're okay tanky with the bear like you were talking about, the lone druid, but Razor's not innately tanky, and Weaver is not innately tanky either, they're both fragility heroes. But we should probably go through the players quickly before the game actually starts up. On the side of Titan, we have got Miracle playing the Lifestealer. Extinct is going to be on that support Windranger. KYXY is going to be playing the mid Storm Spirit. Woman Killer, aka Ice, who used to be in Titan, but he's since left, is going to be playing the support Rubick, and Ohio is going to be in the offlane Clockwork.
On the side of Low Yard, we have Bad Slow Gain playing the Weaver, playing middle, the middle Razor Lance. Of course, on the Vishards, Shangzai. I hope I pronounce it correctly. Mojin on the Sand King, and on the easy lane, DDZ farming his lone Druid.
Yeah, so they are going to be running the mid Weaver for Lo Yan, which should be quite interesting to watch. I feel like Weaver is going to be, I mean, I don't want to say drawing even in terms of harassment on KYXY. I mean, he's got the Shikuchi, so he can kind of run in and out, but KYXY's got that Static Remnant, and I mean, you can see already Weaver's decided to pick up a Magic Stick first item because he knows he's going to have to deal with a lot of harassment and a lot of spamming out from KYXY, and that burst regeneration, I think, should give him a pretty good advantage in terms of laning phase. KYXY might be, you know, happy to pick up a magic stick of his own just to deal with all the Shikuchi spam up that Bad Slow Game is going to be throwing onto him. But I mean, you can kind of see on the bot lane, they're just really wanting to shut down the tri lane coming out from Titan. Just immediately Lance picking up Static Link and kind of just chasing Miracle out of lane, and there's really not that much Miracle can do. I mean, what can he really do against the tri lane coming out from Loyat? Because if he does decide to initiate in, he's just going to get double stunned out and then nuked down by the Visage. And I mean, he can't really initiate with Open Wounds either. He's kind of waiting for a couple more levels onto the two supports. Because, like we were saying, neither Rubick nor Windranger, I would say, are particularly aggressive supports, really. The damage output isn't really that high until a bit later. They're not like a Visage. You can do a, you know, 300 damage or something nuke in the start of the game. You know, they kind of require. Poor Miracle, he can't last hit. He's got minus 28. Well, taking 28 damage onto the Razor. But yeah, I mean, there's two supports from Titan really aren't able to deal a lot of damage, I suppose is what I'm just trying to say. So they can't really win this tri lane by going aggressive. They're just going to have to play passively.
Wow, and the Static Link, just annoying Miracle. He can't really last it anyway. So the good thing is, Titan, they just managed to get a double pull off, denying some farm and experience from Low Yat. And this is gonna hurt them in the long run. The Razor's only level 1, Sand King's level 1, Visage is level 1. On the other hand, pretty much everyone is level 2 except for the Rubick, so they have a bit of an upper hand right now. Of course, when the wave dies, it's gonna be even again. But for now, it's looking quite nicely, and this is giving them some more time. You can see Rubick just roaming the jungle, pulling, stacking, doing stuff, and for this, I mean, in the meantime, they're just kind of drawing even. 3 and 4, and a life slash is 2 and 0, but in these early stages, it's not too big of a deal.
Yeah, I mean, I think Miracle's going to be stuck in this situation where he's really not going to get very much farm from this lane. He's pretty much going to be forced to just wait until KYXY can rotate and maybe get a pick off, which isn't going to happen until KYXY's, well, level 6 or probably more like level 7 or level 8. So that's going to be a bit of, I guess, a bit of trouble for our Titan in terms of this laning phase. But I mean, KYXY's doing decently on farm in the mid lane. 15 to 3 versus, what, 10 to 2 now. So, I mean, Bad Slow Game is keeping up, but KYXY is pulling ahead. We haven't even looked at top lane yet, but DDZ is harassing Ohio a fair amount, but still Ohio is pulling ahead in terms of CS, so he's getting the farm he needs. He's got his bottle up now, and KYXY looks like he's not going to be bottle crowing. He's actually got a regeneration rune already picked up, so it should be good for Ohio to just bottle crow a little bit and use that to kind of outlane DDZ. And he has actually picked up in levels of Cogs. Ooh.
Yeah, I mean, you expect the lone druid to win the lane, to be quite honest. He will outlane the clockwork when he hits the level 5 and the bear has some entangle. So That should be pretty much a one lane there. But on the other hand, as soon as the clockwork hits 6, he will go around the map and just roam and leave the lone druid just doing his stuff on the top lane. So we'll see if they try to like stop the push coming out from the lone druid or not. And on one, no bot lane, no action. I thought that was some go. Sorry.
That's right. Yeah, I mean, for Titan, it doesn't really matter too much if they lose this tri lane. I mean, it's important to not lose a tri lane, but it's not going to be the end of the world because they have got Ohio, who's about tier level 6, and KYXY, who's also about tier level 6, who can just easily rotate in. I mean, one smoke picked up by KYXY or Ohio, and they can just get behind the tower here, and that's going to be, I would say, an assured kill on this bot lane. The levels are still very low, like you were talking about. I mean, you know, level 222.
Wow,
and actually, levels are going the way of Titan at this point because the aggressive tri lane isn't finding the kills they need. So, I mean, Lance is playing very, very aggressively, trying to force Miracle out of lane, but regardless, they're still doing their best. But, I mean, still, the levels are going the way of Titan because they've got this pool camp here. And actually, on top lane, man, diving really, really hard on Ohio. Weaver's come off to join the party, and he might be able to get the first blood now. He's diving to the tower, but he's going to get shots back. He's got 10 one charges, though. He could pass it, but no, he's just going to leave it, and Ohio makes it away on 100 health there.
Those power cogs. Really well done by Ohio. And this is pretty important. I mean, they rotated their mid lane to the top lane to dive behind a tier 2 tower. Bad slow game, he has his bottle, of course, and he did get some mana back. But he tried to, like, he spent everything on these bottles, and this is just given time. And actually, on the bot lane, Rubick is getting initiated. Net, he's taken pretty much damage this aesthetic link, and this is going to be an easy first blood going the way of Lance. And this is exactly what they needed in this aggro tri lane. They need some kills, and they got the first kill. So this is making things interesting, to say at least.
Yeah, and especially the first blood going onto Lance. He can now pick up, even maybe a second kill. Extinct is going to get initiated on. Lance throwing out the plasma field. Nice blocking there. Extinct is unable to get through. He's going to get slowed down now. He pops a cell, but it's not going to be enough. A rotation coming in from a woman killer who's come back to lane, and now Miracle is going to be static linked. He's on the run. He's losing a lot of damage. Down 42 damage, 56. Oh my god, and now woman killer has to watch out. He doesn't want to die again. Mozan is trying to mana himself up, so he has got another stun up, but not going to be finding another kill. I feel like they could have killed off Extinct then, but for some reason, Xiangzai not throwing out the Soul Assumption. Maybe he just didn't have vision.
Yeah, he didn't want to dive really behind the tower because I think there was a creep wave coming. And of course, he didn't have the souls just for the seconds there. He just had one charge or something, and
Lance,
now they go
on
Lance. Nope. Are they? Lance taking quite a bit of damage, and oh, the Fate Bolt just very close. But he's going to pot up, and Xiangzai. Ooh. Close. No one's dying.
Yeah, I mean, that was really well done by Lance there, just using the static link to kind of force Miracle back, because Miracle knows he can't auto-attack Lance to death if he has no damage. Moomin Killer just suicide into the neutrals there. I suppose
he didn't have
any gold to spend. He was just like, whatever, I'll just die. I don't even care anymore. But yeah, really well done there by Lance, just saying, you know, you can't dive me. That's a really good thing about Razor in a laning phase, is that he can kind of just say, you know, not really keep away, but say, hey, you want to dive me? We don't have any damage to do it with.
Rubick deep in top
But KYXY is on the hunt now, looking towards the top lane, it looks like.
And Rubick is there as well. He wants to join the party.
Yeah.
And he
GDZ.
Just... does he smell it? Yeah, he smells something's up. He's staying back very nicely. And they really have to commit so much to just go in there. And some neutrals giving KYXY a very hard time. They really don't want him. And the bear scouts him out. So this should be the end of this bit.
Oh, he does actually get entangled. But no, KYXY is going to be able to make it away. He has got that ball lightning. Even though he doesn't have any bottle charges, he should be fine. And that's a really... Well, a lot of time wasted, I suppose, for KYXY. Since now he is going to be forced back to base.
Oh, bot lane Miracle taking a lot of damage from the static link. Minus 70 damage on him. He doesn't even do... Like, he does... 12 damage now? You can't last it with 12 damage. That's just not impossible. I mean, that's impossible. And in the meantime, Extinct getting his farm up. They're really active with pulling, but the Sand King, he has to say something about it. He can get a nice burst strike up, but a Windrun to save the day. They're gonna go. No vision. And best
looks
game.
Looks like they're gonna be down behind the tower, though.
Yeah, go ahead.
But lots of rotation coming in. Ohio is going to be able to get the Clockwork Cogs off, forcing Weaver back, but he does just pop his ultimate, makes it out okay. Now KYXY is here. He's going to get stunned out by Mozen. Xiangzai does have full souls, but he's not throwing it out for whatever reason. And in comes Miracle, going to be trying to kill down Mozen, but he does just go invisible, blocking the path. And now Lance is in a bit of trouble. He's going to get Electric Vortex here. He's going to go down, but Miracle's going to be the exchange for that. And Mozen goes down, Lance goes down, and Miracle goes down. So two for one trade, I suppose. And now even
No.
Xiangzai could be in trouble. He's completely out of mana. KYXY just ball lightning is across the map, trying to get the slow off. Ohio's out of mana, but it looks like Xiangzai's not going anywhere. He will be just last hit there. Double kill onto KYXY. So was that a 3-for-1 exchange? Losing the lifestealer, but taking down the two supports as well as the trailing farmer of Lance.
Yeah, and Lance rushing a mech, so this mech is going to be a bit delayed. And the faster you can Lone Druid just taking the tower top, and this is... well, actually, back to my point with the mech, I'm sorry, I shouldn't, like, switch topics. The Razor being delayed on his mechanism is... It will hurt them, because, like, sub-10-minute mech is so big for a teamfight. Everyone just has, like, below 1000 HP, and if you get everyone up, it's just incredible, and you can just take towers all around the map. In the meantime, of course, Lone Druid doing his thing. The demolish on the badge is helping out tremendously and taking now on this top tower. And he's up 600 gold, he has his Midas to go, so he's looking good.
Yeah, he should be able to get up a fairly fast Radiance if he chooses to buy that. And I mean, if they do give him space, actually mid lane, bad slow game, could be going down to KYXY, does manage to pop his ultimate, and then sports are coming in. KYXY should be able to make it out from this, just ball lightning away, and they don't have any more disables, and bad slow game has got to watch out, because he does not want to get taken down again. He will just tread switch and bottle himself up, though.
Yep, looking good so far. But this is three guys in the mid lane, and I mean, it's not like they're wasting their time, they do put up quite some pressure on the KYXY. But in the same time, they are not farming it, they're not getting levels, and I would like to see a level 5 on Motion, like ASAP. Good thing they have going for them is the exceptional warding. Just looking at their vision, they have so much vision around the river in the bottom region, and they have total control over this part. So Razor can... Well, Razor can't really farm it. Yeah, now he can.
Yeah, I mean, Miracle's given up on the bot lane and has rotated top, and... I mean, honestly, given the terrible start he had, he's already got up his phase boots and is building towards something else, but... I mean, they are giving him a little bit more space in the top lane. It looks like DDZ doesn't really want to go into that lane. He knows he can't lane too well against the Lifestealer, just because Lifestealer just will regenerate off his bear if he does decide to go for some harassment. He's probably going to need someone else to give him a hand to really stop the farm on Miracle. And of course, I mean, the big problem is, at the moment, Loyat haven't got any stuns, bar Mosin. But, I mean, KYXY is going to be having an absolute field day. What do they have to stop him? The last pick of the Razor was a really nice counter there to the you know, farming Lifestealer, and it does mean that in these mid-game teamfights, Lifestealer's going to have to get up something, you know, big to really stop the Razor from stealing all of his damage. But at the same time, I mean, I think Storm Spirit is going to be the one who's really giving them a lot of grief. He's going to be snowballing forward very, very soon. Already 2-0 with 50 CS, and they've got no real answer to him. I mean, what are they going to use to stop the Storm Spirit?
Yeah, they need some lucky entangles on the bear. And Batslogger going in, doing some big harassment with the DD rune, but he's gonna get static gripped and he's gonna rofle ball away, as you usually say. But still, he's just going in, and another hit, and here comes the super just finishing him off. Kill secured from Motion, and this is like balls to the walls play from Batslow game. Wow, with a DD coming up.
Yeah, that DD was doing huge damage, and KYXY. I feel like he was panicking a little bit. He wanted to get those free hits off, but he was kind of just using all his mana going nowhere, just kind of going around in circles. So, I mean, the kill there going into Mosin is actually really, really good for him, because it does mean he's got his mana boots up now, which is going to be fantastic for him and the Visage. And, I mean, now, a bit of pressure coming onto the mid lane. DDZ, who just rotated between the jungle and back to lane now, is getting his farm up too, and he's almost going to have up... I would say he's going to have a relic up by around about 15 minutes at the rate he's farming now. So that's going to be really, really good for... you know, the pushing coming out from Loyat as well as the team fight. And I mean, given, like you were saying, it's kind of a tri-core versus a single core, I guess a duo core maybe, with the Storm Spirit KYXY. Speaking of him, him and Ohio actually smoked up to the top lane, so they're realizing that TDZ is getting total free farm and they want to shut him down. But is he going to scout it out with the bear again? That is a question.
Yeah, at least they're smoked now. So the bear has to, you know, dispel the smoke. And oh, Ohio, he will find him. Will he go for the hookshot? No, there's some electric vortex. He's trying to... phase shift, but it's not enough. It's just so much damage coming out from KYXY and Ohio. A hookshot was deployed as well, so this is some major hate coming out, but this is a very important kill on the top farm on the side of Lyriot's, topping still 400 TPM.
Yeah, I mean, he's still doing fantastic on the farm, and Lance is actually doing pretty well himself, but behind the tower on the bot lane, Extinct is going to get initiated on. He just TP's out, though, because what do they have to stop him from TPing? They don't have any stuns bar Mosin. And so he literally just TPs in front of four heroes behind the tier 1 tower. So, well, I guess really good reactions there by Extinct, and knowing that the single stun on Loyat is down. So, hey, what's stopping him from TPing out?
Yeah, that was quite... nice. I mean, you have to keep calm in this situation. Good thing Lloyd has going for them is the tier 1 bottom is going to fall. And of course, the Visage having level 6 now. The Familiars are going to be a huge pain if micro'd correctly. And Shang Zai, he can do that. He's pretty damn good on the 0. And some more stuff coming out. Medallion? No. Not yet. Alright. So.
But on top lane.
I missed
it. DDZ gets initiated on by 4. And actually, Lance rotating in as well. He's going to have that mech done, but Plasma Field only level 1 just gets stolen there. But still, another nice pickoff, and Titan are just kind of lurking around the top lane. They knew that at the moment DDZ is going to be the biggest problem. Miracle is just free farming the jungle. He's got the armlet up. I mean, considering the terrible start he had, he's got face bits and armlet up at 14 minutes, which is, well, I guess 13 minutes really, which is absolutely nothing to be ashamed of. That's a very respectable level of farm, and he's actually only being topped at the moment in terms of net worth by that lone druid who's now been killed off twice. So Lance probably needs to lift his game as well as Badso game and catch up, because KYXY and the Lifestealer are going to be pulling ahead of them very soon. And once KYXY gets up this Orchid, I think that Badso game's going to be in a lot of trouble, because he's nowhere near a Lincoln Sphere or a BKB. And what is he really going to do if Storm Spirit just keeps initiating onto him over and over again, just shutting him down?
Yeah, we saw that yesterday with the Storm Spirit just hating on the enemy carry over and over again, just getting pickoffs left and right. And KYXY, he's going for the Orchid, and he should have it up in like 5 minutes tops. Actually, we see no, nothing mid, and then you can just like hate pretty hard. And actually, DDZ is getting initiated again. Ohio is there with the DD, DDZ just dropping down there, and this is hurting his net worth. Now he is pretty much on the same page as the Weaver and the Trilane for Armor Razor, and this is not where he wanted to be and not where he was. So now 3 deaths, wow, just over the pace of like 4 minutes, crazy.
Yeah, and I mean, Loyad probably needs to start making some pressure somewhere else on the map, because if there's 4 heroes lurking around the top lane, I mean, why aren't they kind of pushing down the mid tower or pushing down the T2 bot or doing something to kind of force the attention of Titan away from their carry? And that's really what they need to be doing, because if, you know, if your carry's dying over and over again and you're not getting anything from it, well then that's just like the ideal exchange. And actually, Dadso game could be in trouble too. Ohio's looking to get that hook, but it looks like he won't be able to. And I mean, the aggressive ward's just spotting out anyone who dares go past, you know, this mid lane. I mean, usually when you have the T1 mid tower up, it does mean that your own jungle is safe, but nope, not in this case. The aggressive wards will just be completely scouting out the whole jungle, and meaning that nobody's going to be free to, you know, to get the extra farm from there.
And like this whole area, you can't like farm this, and this is so important for a lone druid. Oh,
look,
wow, here
fails look there.
No, oh, it was Familiars blocking him, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, and bad slow game. How did this shackle not match? Oh, it did latch. I was just having an animation. The hell.
Well, I mean, TDZ, oh man, he's trying to get that farm back up. 1.8k gold in the bank, but he was only on 1.3k at 11 minutes, so he's farmed 500 gold, and that's all going to be reliable gold from that Midas. And that is something really nice about the Midas, is that the gold you get from a Midas is reliable. Well, I'm pretty sure it's reliable gold.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, so it means that even if you die, you're not going to lose it. So, I mean, well, actually, okay, well, KYXY will be okay, because he can just wall out anyway, because they only have one stun. Yeah, so I mean, that is one good thing about the Midas, is that, I mean, if all that fails, at least he's going to get the thingy up, you know, in about 20 minutes from the Midas reliable gold, if all else fails. But hopefully he should get it sooner than that. But Corkling's actually farmed out now at 4 staff, so he's going to be very, very mobile at this point. I mean, when you've got a Lifestealer with the phase boots and actually sitting inside KYXY at the moment, who's ready to go for a bit of a dive.
Yeah, he just picked up the regeneration rune and is back to full HP, ready to go again, and they have such nice vision with this ward deployed by Ned. And will he make a go? No, he's just farming Familiars now. Well, that's 100 gold.
It's a bit hard because Lance is down in the bot lane, but I mean, normally the way that Loyat plays is Lance goes and farms while the rest of his team makes space, but he's gone for a mech, so he has to be in those team fights. And actually, well, they jump out trying to get Badso game, but I mean, you know, normally if you want to have a 4 protect 1 lineup, they'd be doing it perfectly right now. But if Lance is going to be the mech carrier, he has to be in team fights. You can't have a mech carrier who's never there for team fights. But he will be rotating in now, but they still do lose the tower anyway. And KYXY going in very, very aggressively onto Mozen. Mozen should be good to make the way, and KYXY will actually be falling for it. But manages to get a huge hook, pull up power shot, double kill right there. Weaver does pop his ultimate, but he's lifted up into the air. The telekinesis is doing a lot of damage. Extinct is going to be Weaver's target of choice, so he's chasing him down. But at the same time, Clockwork in the middle of the team fight manages to catch both Lance and force type himself out. Lance and DDZ, sorry, that is. Buyout from KYXY, Badso game will be chasing down the Windrunner and manages to get her down. And now, Woman Killer is on 60 health, but last hit is going to be going the way of Badso game. He gets a double kill, but at the same time, KYXY is chasing down DDZ. DDZ's got nowhere to go. He's got 3 heroes onto him, and he is going to be falling as well. Badso game back to base, Lance back to base, and Xiangzai back to base as well. But still, 9-7 at the moment, going the way of Titan. So Titan do seem to be pulling ahead in these team fights, and that buy back from KYXY, definitely not going astray. I think it was worth it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he made the plays happen and he took down DDZ yet again. He's 0-4 and 2, really hurting his net worth there. He now just dropped below all other cores in the game. And this can't happen with a Lone Druid. You want to get this relic up ASAP. You want to split push the lanes. You have a Weaver to do so as well. So, yeah, not going the way of low yet. They really need to step up the game. Thanks. Yeah, I'm doing safety demonstration all day long.
Oh my god, that is like the perfect way to describe you. I love it. All right. Well,
Well, I can go back to camera,
yeah.
like, no problem.
That's great. It's also worth noting that, I mean, when you look at the kills, they look pretty even. I mean, 9-7, nothing to complain about that. KYXY has died off how many times now? Two times, but KYXY is getting the kills. Miracle has only died once, and he's getting kills. Weaver's getting the kills, but I mean, a lot of the deaths for Titan are on the supports, they're not on the cores, whereas the most deaths for Loyat are on this Lone Druid, who has to be that kind of core farming hero for their team. And looks like another death could be going onto Lance now. There is a three-man gank onto him. KYXY rotating in, Shackleshot not going to be left into the trees, but doesn't matter. He manages to get the mech off. Mosen stuns out onto KYXY, but I don't think Lance can really fight this game. We'll be going down. Rotation from Baotzu game coming in, as well as Xiangzai with those familiars, but I think the high mobility on Titan will get them away safe and sound.
And a burst strike stolen on Rubick, and this is gonna make the team fight very interesting. Ned is a great Rubick player, and with a burst strike to boot up with his own stun, wow, he has so much new king, and he just needs the mana. But they have the mana boots up, so that's no problem at all. So they should be good. And Miracle just doing stuff, like cutting
Farming.
off the creep wave behind the tower. Well, this is how he rolls.
No fear. YOLO.
But there is a train coming for him, and maybe DDZ can get a nice entangle, but Miracle, he smells the what's up. And oh, Mosen, he's getting down there, and Obetsu game going in as well, and this is the three-man gank coming out on Miracle, and he's taken very much damage, but he will get the bear, 300 gold in his pockets, and he's gonna infest. Oh, there he goes, and there he goes down. All right, too bad. What a play.
Well, a good attempt by him, but of course, at the same time, this is what I feel like Loyat should have been doing. That, you know, while they were kind of all fighting at the bot lane, Titan pushed down a tier 2 tower. And I mean, while DDZ was getting picked off like 4 times in a row, they should have been pushing the mid tower or the bot tier 2 tower. But Loyat was just kind of, I guess, standing very statically going, "I wonder where they are." Do 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 do. Whereas Titan were going, "Well, Miracle's about to die. Let's get something from this." So at least, you know, he dies, but he gets 200 gold from the tower. Hey, you kind of break even a little bit. But so
Yeah.
yeah, good pushing by Titan, and even though Miracle died, he is still, well, he was top of the net worth. He's just dropped down to second though, but still, he is really keeping up on the farm.
Yeah, I mean, he also got the 300 gold from the bear just because DDZ couldn't, like, stop him from getting it, although there were four guys just ripping him apart. And in the meantime, Weaver's doing some split push stuff. He's picked up an ultimate orb. I would assume it's a man. Not Metastyle, sorry. I mean, it's a Lincoln Sphere, my favorite item ever, especially against Spectre. No, I'm just joking. Please don't kill me, chat. And in the meantime, Lance is just farming middle. Mosin's hanging out in the wings, but he's very far off to his blink. And actually, this is another Shackle Shot on DDZ. Do they have enough damage to take him down? DDZ taken very much damage, but he's still alive somehow. And Woman Killer, aka Ned, he's going down now. What a turnaround. And
Ice.
the. Oh, Ice Ned. What? Ah, sorry.
No, that's right. People asking, it's Ice. Yeah, that was a good turnaround by there, and DDZ surviving. Wow. And he's got the relic now. 22-minute relic. That should have been maybe a 15-minute relic, but still. He lived through a team fight, and that's. Well, not a team fight, he lived through a gank, and that's all he needed.
Yeah, it was a two-man gank. I'm not sure what Titan thought there. Like, they don't have that much damage coming out, and the Lone Druid, he's quite tanky just because of his ultimate form. And he's not that greedy to just stay out in the range form to get brought down easily. He's just pretty much always. Oh, is Batslaw again in a lot of trouble? Yes, he is. He's gonna get silenced, he's gonna get gripped, he's gonna get chewed up by Miracle, and this is a dead Batslaw game. So, that was the problem with the Weaver topping the CS charts and the net worth. Well, not anymore. Miracle firmly on top with a 9k net worth.
Yeah, Miracle's doing quite well for himself. And I mean, Loyat have got the late game, I would say, but One other big thing that we haven't really mentioned is that getting the Radiance up is going to be fantastic for DDZ, but it means that DDZ is probably going to be pushing a lot of the lanes out and keeping his farm up. Well, here is like Weaver going to have to push more aggressively, and until Weaver, say DDZ is keeping the bear in the mid lane, so Weaver's going to have to be pushing down here alone. And while that's good to get some pressure on the lanes, until Weaver picks up that Lincoln Sphere, he's just food for KYXY. There's really no way he can, survive against KYXY's onslaught of damage, so it is something that he's really going to have to be watching out for to ensure that he doesn't get caught out and doesn't get picked off while still getting his farm up while competing with a dual core, well, sorry, with dual carries of the Razor as well as the Silibear. Plus, of course, Mosin's trying to farm a Blink Dagger, and Xiangzai is probably wanting to get off something like a Argonim Scepter sometime soon, or even just Mana Boots. So, really, farm dependent and level dependent heroes on Lo-Yat could be kind of suffering them the game at this point in time.
Yeah, and actually in middle lane they want to make a go there on lands. A nice shackle, but it doesn't ledge on lands. What the hell, Frog? What the hell? Looking at this, no, I don't do any graphs now because there's probably some initiation going on right now. Where's Ohio? He should just go in. Let's go. No, Familiar's just scouting up pretty much everyone. Bad slow game. Shackle not gonna ledge again. Volvo? What?
Worst shackle ever. Yeah, so I mean, Ohio could just go in, but at the same time, maybe he just feels like he doesn't want to. I mean, Bad Soul Game is now on the bot lane doing a bit of pushing, and it looks like, I mean, Titan should be good to get down this next tier 2 tower if they really want to. ready to just keep pushing and keep the pressure up. Yeah, the bear with Radiance is doing its best to defend, but KYXY is ready to go in. He dumps a little bit of a weird direction, but now Lifesteal is going to bounce out. DDZ is in a lot of trouble. He's taking a huge amount of damage, and he's going to be going down. Mosin on the high ground wants to go in, but Xiangzai is going to be the next one to fall. Mosin actually tries to stun out Miracle, but Miracle has got that, well, he hasn't got the rage up anymore, but still. Oh my god, two are going to go down, three are going to go down there. The support's all dead, the lone druid dead, so no more bear for him. And Bad Slow Game wants to defend, but he still does not have that Lincoln Sphere up, so if he goes in, he's probably going to be going down.
What a play by KYXY and Miracle, just going out there and chewing through the life of the lone druid in just a matter of seconds. He couldn't do anything in this fight. And also the Sand King, he just got orchided because they hold on to it instead of wasting it on the lone druid. Just holding on and silencing Mosin as soon as he came back from his invisibility from the sandstorm. So really nicely done there. And he also died to the orchid damage, just not wasting any time on him. It was perfect play by Titan. And this was pretty much the last tier 2 in this upper right, in the upper corner of the map. There's only on their easy lane some standing towers. Well, easy lane of Titan, but they should be going for them quite soon, and after that, well, they can Roach and they can take T3s. Because the gold is looking quite nicely. Actually, we see some initiation going on to Ice. Yep, and Ohio's getting caught out by Mosin, but he turns it around. He wants to go, and this was maybe a little bit of a bad decision there. Ohio taken very much damage with the medallion deployed, and in the meantime, Lifestealer just picks up a kill on the Weaver. Whew.
Well, things not going right for Lo-Yat across the map, really. And I mean, this is the problem with the Tri-Core without too much team fight. I mean, they've got the Epicenter, but I feel like, an Earthshaker probably would have fit in quite well as well instead of the Sand King, giving them just a nice AoE stun that can just kind of say, back off, we're not ready to fight yet. Whereas the Sand King, he needs to get right up and close and personal to really use this stun. So you can kind of see how he's dying off a lot. He was really close to that Blink Dagger, and I mean, he's still quite close to it, but he's probably not going to get it up. At least for a little while, because they're leaving all the farm to this Tri-Core. And I mean, Bad Soy Game isn't getting enough farm, Lance isn't getting enough farm, and neither is really DDZ. Whereas, all the farm has gone the way of just the two cores for Titan. I mean, there's no farm needed on Womankiller on Ice, there's no farm needed on Extinct on the Windranger, really, no farm needed on Clockwork, but of course, they got the farm because their cores were farmed up enough that they could, come into the game and then kind of semi-carry. Whereas, for Lo-Yat, all of their heroes needed something to get started, and so they kind of got caught on a little bit of a back foot at that point.
Yeah, I'm not sure what they have to pick up, which can deal with the Lifestealer in the later stages of the game, because currently they really lack some damage. Lance can do some static Link stuff, of course, and he hits pretty hard there, and he has BKB to boot, but still he needs to get his right clicks on. And currently Miracle is just playing so smart. He invests in the right time. He goes around the map with KYXY, and also in the team fight, just pretty much chewing through everybody. So really nicely done there. And they need to get some damage item up, and they need to get ASAP and a Saint Inyasha to boot, just some more movement speed. And Miracle, he can be now in a lot of trouble. Nope, doesn't look like. Entangle, and he rages out of it. Nicely done by Tioko's KYX, but he goes in. He goes in five, guys. It is a BKB deployed. Motion does absolutely dropping. Lands with his BKB activated. He's leeching a crap ton of damage. 56 damage leech on him. Actually, that's not too much, and he's not hitting anything. So for now, just KYX by going down for this... Whoa, I hear a hookshot. Lily, take over, please.
Okay, where's the hookshot going?
I don't know.
Woman Killer is going to get taken down. Where is Ohio? Ohio is a base, so... Maybe he was just hookshotting around the map for funsies. But still, I mean, a good trade there, honestly, for Luya. Getting down two, especially taking down KYXY, who was really pulling ahead in terms of farm. That's something they needed to do quite desperately. And now they could go for him with the Roshan Pit. KYXY not up for 40 seconds. They probably want to take down Miracle, but Miracle's really, really fat at this point. So, no, it looks like they're just going to go straight into the Roshan Pit. It's going to be a 3v5 situation. Xiangzai, quite low on health, but hey, he's not too worried, and... Oh, it looks like Mosin's going to be going down in the mid lane. Nice shackle shot followed up by the Clockwork Cook will be taking him down. But now Bowser Games kind of distracting them away from the Roshan Pit. He could get stunned up by Miracle, but no, he does just use that kiting ability. Now Miracle's in a lot of trouble. He's surrounded, but he jumps inside of the creep wave there. And Xiangzai does get taken down. He has no damage, but it doesn't matter if he's just going to be hiding inside the creep. He's in that one there, but they can't deny it. They don't have a chance to send it back to base either. They know it's in there. They know that Miracle is hiding inside there. But KYX was back up, and Miracle will just be able to hop out and run away.
Oh, that could have went so much worse for Titan. But still, oh, Ohio missing a hookshot, but it's no big deal. He has his Aghanim's up to pin 2 boot, just 12 seconds on this hookshot. Yeah, so no problem at all. Just fishing for a hook is always fine with the Clockwork with an axe. And now they're gonna take the Roshan for themselves. Are they gonna make a play out of this low yet? Looks like they just defend the base. Interestingly enough, Lone Druid has 2 TP scrolls. One of which is Miracles. Alright.
Yeah, and Lee Weaver finally got the Lincolns up, so, I mean, that does mean he can split push, but I mean, at this point, I don't know if split pushing is really going to be a viable option, given the Clockwork's got up an Arcanum Scepter. And speaking of Arcanum Scepter, he's just going to go straight into the bear. That bear did it. No, it's not just resummoned. That bear is going to be able to be resummoned now, but it does mean...
Oh, what a shackle!
DDZ and Lance. KYXY is going in. Lance immediately dead. DDZ. DDZ, DDZ, I don't know, he's going to be going down next. Miracle getting the last hit. Lone Druid does buy back, he resummons the bear. Good thing he didn't resummon the bear just then. Otherwise, he wouldn't have had a bear for 2 minutes, but still. Clockwork picking up a Blink Dagger. Oh, Ohio. Ohio likes that Blink Dagger on the Clockwork. So, interesting item choice, but regardless, I mean, Titan do have the ability to push the high ground now if they want to.
Ohio just hooked into the base. Like, he TP'd into the base, went back, and hooked on. To the Windrunner, quite nice. Alright, thing is with the buyback on DDZ, it hurts him so much. He didn't get anything out of it. He still can't get unreliable gold. And so what is he gonna do? It didn't accomplish anything. Titan was very smart. As soon as they saw the buyback, they just immediately TP'd back. And Weaver wasn't in the position to chase, nor was anyone else. So yeah, it hurts. It hurts. And this is looking now. A bit grim. 14k gold lead, as well as actually we see another hook on DDZ. He's taken very much damage, yeah, and the Wind Ranger just to finish it off. And Loyad can't make a play out of this.
I mean, there's really not much that Loyad can do. I mean, look at the score, 21 to 11. Gold, 14,000 lead experience, 15,000. Ohio just going into the base and then blinking out. Ah, oh, what a guy. And now, Ruby picked up an Arcanum Scepter, so if he can steal that Visage Familiars, that's going to make him a happy guy. I guess Razor's Ultimate would also be a nice one to steal. Or, of course, Sand King with the Epicenter. They're all pretty nice spells for him to steal that'll give him a lot of presence in the team fights. Especially I would say Razor's, since they are trying to push the high ground now. If he can steal Razor's Ultimate, he would just be a happy, happy chappy.
And Miracle picked up an Abyssal Blade. So whoever is going to get initiated, he's going to... die, okay, scratch that, Lance is gonna be completely fine. Just because KYX wasn't there, but I assume Miracle will hop into KYX and they should make a go on the Lone Druid or the Razor just in a second here. And actually now they're gonna go, Lance taking very much damage, a Burst Strike, but it doesn't do anything, everyone had his BKB or the Rage activated. Xiangzai, he's taken so much damage as well, just gonna get dropped there by KYX and Miracle. Bad slot game, can't do anything against it. There's no one dying on the side of Titan as of yet. Now finally the Aegis is triggered. Ohio just fishing for a hook again. Abyssal Blade, and now they're on the run. Is Ohio gonna go down? Yep, nope. The mech is gonna...
Oh.
Wow, what a mech. No one's dying.
and so, well, they just don't have any damage. Woman Killer should be good to make it away. Visage Familiars are chasing him down, but four staff out by Extinct, and he's stolen the Shikuchi, and now they're going to go back in. Lance, who just bought out, is going to pop in that mech, try to keep himself alive, but they have no damage to take down Miracle. Miracle is auto-attacking Lance to death. In comes the Silibear. We'll be able to get off an Entangle, but look at this. He's got two of the three cores taking him down, and still, he's just ignoring it. And he comes back out of the Cooper in full health. KYX were completely out of mana, but what are they going to do against him? Because Miracle, what a shackle! My god, Extinct with this Windrunner. Taking out DDZ yet again. Woman Killer now chasing after Mosin. Mosin, he doesn't know what to do. He's going to get lifted up into the air, thrown into the Lifestealer, and GG will be called out now by Lance.
Wow. Wow, Titan just going ham in this game. That was crazy.
Yeah, I mean, GG, well played to both teams. Thank you.